Hello friends, welcome once more to Class Online. My name is Tutor Dami, and in this edition we shall be looking at Jamb Physics 2011 question number 21 to number 25, and we shall be dealing with Jamb. Now don't forget that if you learn something from this video, click on like button. We have a lot to share with you that will better help you understand physics. Let's get to number 21. Which of the following type of wave need a medium for evaporation? Do you have any idea? Is it radio wave, X-ray, sound wave, or light wave? Now, actually, the wave that needs a medium is called mechanical wave. Why the wave that needs a medium is called mechanical wave? Why the wave that do not need a medium is called electromagnetic wave? Right? Now, which one is mechanical that needs a medium? All others are electromagnetic except one. One is mechanical because it needs a medium, and only mechanical wave needs medium. Now, do you have any idea? Is it radio wave, X-ray, sound wave, or light wave? Is there anything coming to your mind? Now, the answer is super simple. All of them are actually electromagnetic except one. Now, remember the electromagnetic guys. They are given by the summary of all the electromagnetic guys that do not need medium is revox G. R is what? Radio wave. I is visible. It's infrared. V is visible light. It's not on the list. Then U is ultraviolet ray. X is X-ray. And G is gamma. Now those are the that's the summary of the electromagnetic waves, right? But that means they are the ones that do not need medium. So because I said revox G are the ones that do not need, so they are the electromagnetic. Radio wave does not need, because radio wave is among the electromagnetic wave, it does not need a medium. So radio wave is out, because it is revox G is the formula, it's all of them. So re is radio wave. Re, I is infrared. We don't have infrared here. Then vo is visible light, and that's light here. It doesn't need, so light is out, radio is out, vo, visible light is out. Then U, ultraviolet ray, is not there. It's out. Then X, that's X-ray, is also out. So, and G is gamma. So, they are all electromagnetic wave, and they don't need a medium. So, they are all out. But the only one that does need a medium is sound wave. And that is the answer. The answer is, there are two. So, sound wave is a type of mechanical wave under longitudinal wave. So sound wave need a medium, and that medium is mostly air. So water wave also need a medium, but these waves here, they don't need a medium. So the one that need a medium, simple put, is sound wave, and that is the answer. Number 22, the ground is always cold. That should be cold, not cold, at night, because the what? Why is the ground cold at night? Is it because the sun no longer shines at night, or atmosphere reflects the sun's energy at night, or atmosphere absorbs the sun's energy at night, or the earth radiates it on the atmosphere at night? Do you have any idea which one might be right? Now, the answer is super simple. Now, this is Biliki. She is cold at night because the ground is cold, right? Now, why is she, and why is it so? Why is it so? Now, do you have any idea which one might be right? Now, the simple reason is this. In the afternoon, when the sun shines, the ground is hot. But in the night, when the sun is gone, the ground begins, and the atmosphere is cool, the ground begins to lose heat. When you lose heat, you will become cold. So cold is not an energy. Cold is just the absence or the leaving of heat. When heat keeps going away and going away and going away, that body will start getting very cold. So cold is the absence of heat. And the reason is because earth radiates heat on the atmosphere at night. The earth radiates means to shine. The earth is sending out heat. In the daytime, it is taking in heat, but at night, it sends out the heat, and therefore, and as it is sending out the heat, it is getting colder and colder and colder and colder. So in the night, the earth sends forth the heat it has taken, and then it becomes very cold, and that is the reason why the ground is cold at night. Remember, when you give out heat, you get cold, and that is the answer to the question. Super easy, right? Now, number 23 says, a metal of volume 400 centimeter cube is heated from 30 degrees Celsius to 90 degrees Celsius. The increase in volume is what? Now, does this ring any bell to you? Now, this question is super. It's a question. You are seeing volume. is a question on expansivity, volume expansivity. But I was expecting that they would have put the actual linear expansivity of metal in the question. I believe it should be around the question. Maybe it was a typographic error. There should be linear expansivity of metal should have been given. That means this question is looking a little bit not complete. I don't believe that you can be giving this kind of question in exam without the linear expansivity of metal. So now, but however, because they mention volume, you are going to be working with volume expansivity first. So that means volume expansivity is Y. I call it Y equals change in volume. That's the formula over volume times change in temperature. You must have seen this before under the topic expansivity. Now, volume or cubic expansivity, right? Now, I'm to find the increase in volume or the change. It is still the same thing as change in volume. So I will make this change in volume the subject of formula. It will come down here, and this one will multiply themselves. And that will become, but first of all, the first thing that I did was that I changed because I wasn't giving the volume expansivity, but the linear expansivity of metal. So I will have to work with volume expansivity of metal is 3 times the linear expansivity. You, in most cases, you will not be given the volume expansivity. You will only be given the linear expansivity. And that is, volume is linear, is 3 times linear. And that is it. So I change this volume into 3 times linear expansivity of metal. And that's it. Equals change in volume, that's increase in volume over volume times increase or change in temperature. So now making the increase in volume the subject, that will become increase in volume equals 3 times linear. This one will come here and multiply this. Why this one will go down? That will come increase in volume equals 3 times linear expansivity times volume times change in temperature. And that will give me change in volume equals 3 times. What is the linear expansivity? It wasn't given, but I could figure it out. And that's 2 times 10 to the power -5. I believe it will be given, so you might not have to memorize it. 2 times 10 to the power -5 times the volume itself is 40 times the temperature change, that's 90 to 30, and that will give me 3 times this 2 times 10 to the power -5 is 0.00002 times 40 times 90 minus 30 is 60. If you multiply all these things, you'll be getting 0.144 cm³ as cube, not square, please, as your change in volume. And that is the answer to the question. Don't forget where we came from, and don't forget the modification. It is that simple. And the answer is therefore, the answer is not even there. And that means that the question is not even correct itself. And that is the answer for number 23. Let's number 24, change of state, diffusion, radiation, osmosis. Which of the processes above can be explained using the kinetic theory? Now, kinetic theory says that matter contains molecules that are always moving, right? Now, when state is changing from solid to liquid, liquid to gas, the molecules are moving. Like if you have an ice block, the water molecules are not moving. But when it melts into liquid, it has changed state. It has changed from solid to liquid. That means the molecules have become free. They are now moving freer. They are now freer than they were before. Now when the water changes each further and becomes steam, the molecules have become very free. So it is all showing movement of molecules. You know, kinetic theory shows that states that molecules are moving randomly. So this change of state shows that molecules are consistently moving, and that means that change of state is correct. Then diffusion is what happens when you spray a perfume in one part of the room and you are perceiving it at the other part of the room. Now diffusion shows that molecules of that perfume could move from the part of the room where you spray it to the other part where you perceive it, and that also shows that molecules can move. Now that supports the kinetic theory of matter. Now radiation is energy, like what happens when the sun shines. Radiant energy comes from the sun and comes to the earth, right? But that is not matter, that is just energy. So the radiation does not show that matter, because kinetic theory has to do with matter. The energy coming from the sun is not matter, it is pure energy, it is just heat energy. And that is just it. So radiation does not really have to do with matter. You know, it is energy, but it is not matter. It is not, no matter, anything that have weight and occupy space. But does it occupy space? No, it is just energy, and that is just it. So it is not under matter, so it does not support the kinetic theory of matter. So it is out, radiation is out. The ray of the sun comes down, but that thing coming out is not a matter, it is just energy. While osmosis is the movement of what? substance across a semi-permeable membrane, okay, from a region of high concentration to a region of low concentration across a semi-permeable membrane. And that's osmosis. Osmosis happens in the root of plant when water is entering into the plant through the roots. So that also has to do with matter moving, okay? But so the answer is simply the ones that support are 1, 2, and 4. But 3, radiation is out. So the answer is 1, 3, 4. And that is, 1, 2, 4. And that is the answer for number 24. Number 25 says the human eye loses its power of accommodation. The difference is when the human eye loses its power of accommodation, the difference is known as what? Is it astigmatism? Is it astigmatism or long-sightedness or short-sightedness or presbyopia? Do you have any idea? When you are in a dark room and the light comes off suddenly, you have to squeeze your eye. That's called accommodation. But when your eye cannot accommodate again, what is that problem called? Now, the simple answer is just presbyopia. The answer is presbyopia because presbyopia is caused by the hardening of the lens of your eye, which occurs with aging. It happens with aging when the lens of the eye cannot adjust to light. You know, when light is too bright, you have to squeeze your eyes. But when you are in a dark room and there's no light, you have to open your eyes to see. You have to take in enough light because you need light in your eyes to be able to see. So you are to the bright room, you have to squeeze. To the dark room, you have to open. It is called accommodation. That means you are adjusting your eyes to light, and that is it. But when the eye can't accommodate, it is presbyopia. And it happens with aging, and it is caused by the lens of the eye is no more flexible. It's now hard or rigid. And this, as your lens becomes less flexible, it can no longer change shape to focus on close-up image. And that problem is called presbyopia. And that is the answer for number 25. And that brings us to the end of this series. Don't forget, if you learn something from this series and you want to get more content, click on the like button. We have a lot to share with you that will better help you understand things. Until you see again, take care of yourself and bye for now.